Welcome to Avipedia 2016 mains discussion. Now we will discuss question from international affair, and question is: international communities have failed Syrian people critically examine. So I think सबसे पहले तो हमें इस question का context समझना जरूरी है. तो sir, what should be the context of this question?
इस question का context है कि Syria में जो civil war हो रही है, that has been complicated by involvement of Russia, US, ISIS and the Kurds. तो ये जो civil war है, इसका एक peaceful solution होना चाहिए था, जैसे ये लोग तालिबान इन अफगानिस्तान का कर रहे हैं through a dialogue. But यहाँ पे war continue हो रही है, and because of this there are many humanitarian issues that are coming out and people are suffering a lot.
So the main context should be on humanitarian grounds.
Right.
Okay.
इसके अंदर it is the geopolitical tussle between USA and USSR, sorry, Russia.
Yes.
Now Russia is backing Bashar al-Assad, the current president of Syria.
Okay.
Whereas USA wants Bashar al-Assad to go, leave office, and wants to usher democratic changes in Syria. This is the main tussle.
Okay.
Now there are, apart from these two, there are two more stakeholders here. One is ISIS.
Okay.
And the other are the Kurds who live in the border region of Syria, Turkey and Iraq. So ye jo Syria, Turkey, Iraq mein jo Kurds hai, they are ethnic people, they want their own land, they want their own state there.
They are supported by whom? US or
they are Russia? Actually they are supported by US here.
Okay.
And US wants them to fight against ISIS. Because US does not want their own army men to directly engage in Syrian war.
Okay, so you have explain the Syrian crisis. Now I think we should move toward the question. How international communities have failed Syrian people? International community ne kis tarah se Syrian people ko?
International communities, for example, Red Cross.
Okay.
They should have provided aid, timely aid to the people of Syria. And wahan pe refugee camps bhi hone chahiye the.
Okay.
Now, probably it is the ISIS involvement which has made the situation very volatile there.
So can we blame Red Cross or not?
No, it is the involvement, it is the violent aspects of the conflict there, jiski wajah se humanitarian aid pahunch nahi pa rahi hai andar. And the border across the Syrian border along Turkey has been closed because Turkey has refused to accept any refugees.
And what about the other European countries surrounded by Syria?
Iraq on the northeast, southeast front of Syria. Is also reeling under pressure of ISIS there.
So they are not helping Syria.
They cannot help. They are not in a position to help.
Okay.
Lebanon there, it's a small nation. Now, वहाँ से जो east जो उनका sea route है, वहाँ से the people go towards France and Germany. So initially they were being accepted there, and the reason was that they'll provide cheap labor in European nations. But now after rehabilitating so many refugees, European nations say ki if we accommodate more, this would affect our demographic profile.
Okay.
And fuel inflation and cause instability, economic instability. So iski wajah se the people of Syria have been displaced, they are internally displaced and no international community is coming forward.
And what about the United Nations?
See, US and Russia are both permanent members of UN. Now when permanent P5 fight together, when there's infighting, this renders UN ineffective as an institution to ensure world peace.
And what about the India?
India has been following a policy of non-involvement with Syria.
Okay.
Because it has good relations with Shia states that are Iran, Iraq, as well as Syria, and the Sunni states also, such as Saudi Arabia. India's interests in that region are to ensure energy security, that is import of oil.
Okay.
Now if India intervenes and takes sides there, that might spoil its relations with the other nation.
But don't you think that India should provide help for the Syrian people on humanitarian grounds?
India's involvement should solely be guided by its national interests, and here national interests are dominantly energy security. So India has been not being involving in this region, but has diverted its attention towards the Central Asian region, such as the Caspian region, Kazakhstan, nuclear deals.
Okay. I think we should conclude the question.
Right.
Okay. Thank you.